هذا القرآن يوحدنا لطريق الخير يوجهنا. الله تعالى أنزله ورسول الله معلمنا.
The children of Israel, sal bani Israela, kam atainahum min ayatin bayyina. Ask the children of Israel, how many clear signs we have given them. Anyone who substitutes the favor of Allah after it has come to him should know that Allah is strict in retribution. The life of this world is charming to those who are unbelievers, and they mock at those who believe. But they forget that those who fear Allah will rank above them on the day of resurrection. Allah gives sustenance without measure to whom He wants. Wallahu yarzuqu man yasha'u bighayri hisab. In the last juz that we read yesterday, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was speaking to the Bani Israel, O children of Israel, remember my blessings upon you. And now in this juz, how is Allah speaking? Ask the Bani Israel. Notice the third person. When does a person who is speaking to one person and then turns his face away and says, ask him, why did he do this? What is it showing us? The anger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let us hope we don't fall into that category too, because whatever the Bani Israel did is a mirror for us. We need to check our own actions against what they did. Allah says, ask the children of Bani Israel. Ask the children of Israel, how many clear signs we had given them. Anyone who substitutes the favor of Allah, what is the biggest favor of Allah? The Quran, the revelation. After it has come to him, should know that Allah is strict in retribution. They changed their divine scripture and hence earned Allah's wrath. And they should know that the life of this world is very glamorous, very charming, very attractive. But to whom? To the disbelievers. As a person's iman goes on increasing, the love for this dunya and whatever it contains goes on decreasing. Why? Because we know that there is something much more beautiful, much more amazing waiting for the believers in the hereafter. Why should we disobey Allah for these petty trinkets of this worldly life? Allah gives sustenance without measure to whoever He wants. Mankind was one nation, having one religion. Later, when people invented other religions, Allah appointed prophets as bearers of good news and warnings and revealed to them the book with the true guidance to settle the matters of dispute between people. But the very people to whom it was given, they started disputes after the clear arguments had come to them because of rivalry between one another. Allah has guided the believers by His will to the truth in those matters in which they had differences. Allah guides whom He pleases towards the right way. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, if people argue because of lack of knowledge, which is natural, then what should they do? They should turn towards Allah's guidance. What does the Quran and Sunnah say about it? Number one, there are two types of difference of opinion. One kind of difference of opinion is not dislike. Like two people, one may be liking one color. Let's say one sister likes pink, the other sister likes blue. Is there something wrong with that? Certainly not. This is the beauty of our deen. A little here and there, this is one person's opinion, another scholar's opinion is this, another scholar's opinion is this. Nothing wrong with that. That is the beauty of deen. There's diversity in our deen. However, when does it become wrong? When we start issuing fatwas of kafirs to the others, when we start developing enmity for the other sect, when we start saying, oh, only I'm going to enter Jannah, my sect will enter Jannah, you're all going to go to hell. That is what displeases Allah. Allah has allowed minor difference of opinion. That's okay. Even the Sahaba-i-Karam had minor differences of opinion, and Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam did not object to that. However, none of them hated each other. None of them became the enemies of each other. None of them said, I'm not going to read my prayers in the masjid of that one. No, they were all brothers. And that is what the need of today is. Ummat-e-Muslima, come together, become brothers. If somebody says something and somebody else has a different opinion, so what? We are allowed to do that. It's allowed in Islam. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, do you think that you will enter paradise without any trials? While you have known the examples of those who passed away before you, they were afflicted with suffering and adversity and were so violently shaken up that even the messenger and the believers with him cried out, Mata Nasrullah. They cried out, when will the help of Allah come? Allah, inna nasrallahi qareeb. Meaning when trials and tribulations come upon us and we feel, oh my goodness, how can I bear it? So many troubles have come on me. Altogether, we need to remember the Sahaba Ikram went through much more than this. Remember Bilal radiallahu anhu. Remember Khabbab bin Arth. Remember all those people who were tortured. Did they give up Islam? Did they give up obedience to Allah? No, they did not. They remained steadfast on their deen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says they were tested. Their iman was being tested. And remember, the bigger the test, the higher the reward for that. So when they were tested, the believers asked their prophets, Mata Nasrullah. They were tested so much that they asked their prophet, when will the help of Allah come? And Allah answered himself, Allah, inna nasrallahi qareeb. Know that Allah's victory is close. Allah's help is close. It's near. When we feel we are going through a bottleneck, what is there at the end of the bottleneck? The opening. It means after every night when the darkest hour of the night comes, that is the time when daybreak is about to come. Just hold on. Just be patient. Allah's help is near. Allah inna nasrallahi qareeb. They ask you what they should spend in charity. Yes, alunaka maza yunfiqoon. Qul man faqtum min khayrin. Falil walidaini wal aqrabina wal yatama wal masakini wabni sabil. Wama tafalu min khayrin. Fa inna allaha bihi alim. They ask you what they should spend in charity. Say, whatever you spend with a good heart, give it to parents. Give it to relatives, orphans, the helpless and travelers in need. Whatever good you do, Allah is aware of it. Fighting has been made obligatory for you, much to your dislike. It is quite possible. Wasa antakrahu shayyam. وَهُوَ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ وَأَسَانْ تُحِبُّ شَيْئًا وَهُوَ شَرٌ لَكُمْ وَاللَّهُ يَعْلَمُ وَأَنْتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُ. Amazing ayat. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, it is quite possible that something which you do not like is good for you, and that something which you love is bad for you. And Allah knows, and you do not know. They asked Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam what they should spend in charity, and what is the answer Allah is giving? Whatever you spend, Allah knows it. And who should be spent on first? The parents. Why? Because we all spend on our families, our children, spouse, etc. Sometimes we are so engrossed in spending on our children, we forget our poor parents. And what do parents need? Sometimes they are not in a position to spend. And sometimes they don't want our money. They want our time. Sometimes they are not in need of anything else except that we just spend a little time with them, visit them, sit with them, talk nicely with them, be gentle and loving, listen to their stories which they may be repeating over and over again. Don't say, oh, I've heard this one. Just listen with a smile as if you are hearing for the first time. Because the word spend, Allah does not specify that it only refers to money. It means spend anything for Allah, including our time, our talent, our efforts. So Allah says, whatever you spend with a good heart, give it to parents, relatives, orphans, helpless, and travelers in need, and Allah is aware of it. And then Allah says, it is possible that something which you want desperately, which you love and which you make dua, oh Allah, I must have this, please give it to me. And you say, why isn't Allah giving it to me? I think this thing, if it had happened, it would have been so good. And Allah is not giving it to me. And something else which is happening in my life, I think, oh my goodness, why is this happening? Why to me? Why only me every time? And Allah says, Allah knows and you do not know. Allah knows the benefits hidden in that. Which you think is bad, it is actually extremely good for you in the long run. And what you think is good for you will be very harmful for you. Allah knows our future, our present and past, as well as He knows what's going on right now. For us, we are blind. We are blind to the future. We can see our present only a little bit, and past sometimes we forget, and future we are completely blind, but Allah knows. They ask you about war in the sacred month. Tell them, fighting in this month is a big offense. But to prevent from the path of Allah, to deny Him, to prevent an access to and expel His worshippers from Al-Masjid Al-Haram are more severe crimes in the sight of Allah. Preventing people from coming towards Allah is a bigger crime in the eyes of Allah. How do we prevent people from coming towards Allah? Sometimes by our actions. The non-Muslims look at the way we behave and they say, oh, if this is Islam, thank you very much. I don't want to be a Muslim. What does this mean? Through our actions, we are preventing people from coming towards Allah. Sometimes we say such things about our deen that other people don't want to come. Sometimes we make deen so difficult that people say, oh my goodness, I can't do this. And what did Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam teach us? Yassiru wa la tu'assiru wa bashiru wa la tunaffiru. Yassiru, make things easy for people. وَلَا تُعَسِّرُوا, don't make life difficult for them. وَبَشِّرُوا, give them good news. وَلَا تُنَفِّرُوا, do not repel them, do not make them hate it, do not make them turn away from it. And we are doing just the opposite. So Allah says, prevent an access to and expel His worshippers from Al-Masjid Al-Haram are more severe crimes in the sight of Allah, and mischief is worse than killing. As for the disbelievers, they will not cease fighting until they succeed in turning you back from your religion. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and mischief is worse than killing, wal fitnatu akbaru min al qatl. In the eyes of Allah, creating mischief is even worse than murder, even worse than killing, because mischief applies to the masses. People become terrorists, they blow up schools, they blow up masajid, they blow up other things. Innocent people, what crime have they done? And they say Allahu Akbar while detonating the bomb. يهدنا لطريق الخير يوجهنا الله تعالى